Hey everyone, and welcome to Skillcapped. In this guide, we're going to be breaking down what exactly is strafe shooting and counter strafing. These are two mechanics that will help you win more gunfights by making you significantly harder to hit, basically dodging the enemy's bullets while your gun is still perfectly accurate. At the same time, it's an essential skill to have in order to utilize certain techniques such as jiggle peeking, which can allow you to destroy enemies trying to hold an angle on you. Now, strafe shooting and counter strafing are usually considered more advanced techniques that players can find difficult to master. But don't worry, as in this guide, we'll be breaking it down into simple steps so you can quickly and easily understand how to master this mechanic. And if you're serious about improving, then go to skillcap.com to unlock our hyper improvement system that will teach you how to win more gunfights, master your agent, and so much more. Backed by our ranked improvement guarantee, you have nothing to lose. So come join over 500,000 satisfied members of Skillcapped, improve the KDA, and get the rank you've always wanted at skillcap.com. Link in the description below. Alright, so first, what exactly is strafe shooting? Strafe shooting is when you move from side to side, taking shots right before you change directions. This is because you are standing still during this point, and so your bullets will be completely accurate before you move again. For example, I hold the A key to move left, then release the A key. I come to a standstill so my bullets will be perfectly accurate. I shoot a small 2-3 bullet burst, and then hit the D key to move to the right. I then release the D key to stop moving so I'm accurate again, shoot a small burst, and then hit the A key to move to the left. I can then repeat this process back and forth, causing my burst of bullets to be completely accurate while moving in between them to make me hard to hit. So now that you understand what is strafe shooting, what is the value of using this technique? Well, a target that is standing still is always easier to hit. Tell me if this doesn't sound familiar. You peek a corner. Both you and the enemy spot each other, and immediately crouch and spray with whoever lands the most bullets or a headshot, winning the fight. By strafe shooting, you can avoid this scenario and instead have the opponent be an easy target to hit since he's standing still, while you're much more difficult to hit as you're moving between your shots. In addition to this, it's an essential skill to have when peeking corners. Most players will peek a corner and on making contact with an enemy, immediately be locked into a fight to the death. With strafe shooting, you can peek around corners, take a quick burst of accurate bullets, and then get behind cover to safety. Great, so now that we understand what is strafe shooting and why we do it, what exactly is counter strafing? Counter strafing is an alternate method to strafe shooting where instead of letting go of the strafe key, you begin to strafe in the opposite direction immediately. Players with previous tactical FPS experience are much more accustomed to using counter strafing rather than the letting go method of strafe shooting we mentioned earlier, because games like Counter-Strike have much more momentum with their movement. By counter strafing, you're able to cancel this momentum and change directions or come to a standstill faster. As you remember earlier in the video, the example we used for strafe shooting was holding the A key to move left, then letting go of the A key to stop moving, then taking your shots once you're standing still, and then hitting the D key to move in the opposite direction. However, when it comes to counter strafing, rather than letting go of the A key to stop moving and then coming to a standstill, we immediately press the D key at the same time as releasing the A key. This will cause us to turn directions much faster, and as the name says, we counter our initial strafe with another strafe in the other direction. And here's the trick to counter strafing. During the brief moment where you are transitioning between the two different strafes, you can shoot 1-2 bullet bursts. This is because the game interprets you to not be moving fast enough to cause inaccuracy during that transition. As you can see, when we compare regular strafe shooting on the left to counter strafing on the right, counter strafing allows you to shoot the exact same amount of bullets, but you are much more faster and more evasive. One of the other benefits of counter strafing is that you can actually use it to come to a standstill faster. For example, if we hold the A key and are moving to the left and then see an enemy and want to come to a standstill to be accurate, we can let go of the A key. However, it takes time with the momentum we have to come to a perfect standstill. This is what counter strafing can help solve. If we're in the same situation and are holding the A key, then see an enemy and want to come to a standstill, instead of just letting go of the A key, we can tap the D key once right as we let go of the A key to quickly stop our momentum and get to a standstill faster. Essentially, you don't need to do full strafes in order to get the full benefits of counter-strafing. If instead you just want to stop in place as fast as possible, you can tap the opposite strafe key quickly to stop your momentum quicker. Alright, so why do the pros find counter-strafing to be so important? First, when strafe shooting, counter-strafing simply allows you to change directions faster, making you more evasive while allowing you to still shoot accurate bursts of bullets between the direction change. Second, when you want to come to a standstill, counter-strafing will allow you to cancel your momentum and become fully accurate faster. Putting the time and effort into learning counter-strafing is a cornerstone skill you'll need in order to execute a variety of different mechanics in Valorant. For example, if you want to use a mechanic called jiggle peeking, which involves quickly peeking a corner and then going back to cover, counter-strafing becomes essential, as without it you'll either be standing still in the open for too long while you shoot, or not know you can fire a volley of accurate bullets at the time of your direction change. Knowing how to counter-strafe also unlocks the ability to jiggle peek into pre-firing a common angle. Again, the same concept, by counter-strafing you can minimize the amount of time you're exposed to the enemy, get behind cover fast, and still fire a burst of accurate bullets. Alright, now let's get into teaching exactly how to strafe shoot and counter-strafe. We've divided this section into three different difficulty levels depending on your skill. So let's start with the beginner version first. A useful trick for beginners to understand how movement affects your gun's accuracy is actually just a quick setting option. Make your way to the settings menu by pressing the escape key if you are in game. Select the crosshair tab at the top, and scroll down to the inner lines and outer lines categories. Look for an option called movement error, then turn it on for both lines. This small tweak to your crosshair will now change its size to display how inaccurate or accurate you are based on your movement. As you can see, if you decide to strafe at full speed, the crosshair expands drastically when compared to your smaller crosshair when you're just standing still. This will help visualize the timing when your bullets will be accurate by shooting when the crosshair is in its small state. Now with our handy visual aid to see when we are accurate, let's actually break down the inputs needed to strafe shoot. First, begin a strafe in a direction. For our example, we'll use left or the A key. Press and hold the A key. Once you get to the point where you want to stop, just let go of the A key. The important factor here is that you have to pay attention to the timing of when you are accurate again. Try your best to begin shooting whenever the crosshair resets back to being small. This will result in shooting accurate bursts. After you are finished shooting the desired amount of bullets, begin another strafe in the opposite direction by pressing the D key. All you have to do now is repeat the process of letting go of the D key to stop moving, firing your weapon when accurate, stopping your shots, and then strafing again. You now know the inputs for strafe shooting. Remember that shooting while being accurate is the number one rule we need to follow to have clean form. Practice it slowly and do each action individually. With time, you'll want to begin to speed up the process, pushing yourself to strafe faster while making sure you're still firing accurately. Great, now that you've learned the beginner version of strafe shooting, let's move on to the more advanced version, which incorporates counter-strafing. Earlier, we discussed how using the movement error crosshair configuration helps to learn how our accuracy is linked to our speed. But, much like how you lose your training wheels when you learn how to ride a bike, you ideally want to turn this option off when you get more comfortable with your mechanics. This is because the majority of players find that having a dynamic crosshair incredibly distracting when focusing during their games and lining up headshots. The ability to see when they are accurate during movement becomes less of an issue whenever they can intuitively feel their movement accuracy and contract their bullet markers. Next, we'll be incorporating counter-strafing so that we can strafe shoot faster and become more evasive. For this scenario, we'll begin by strafing left by holding the A key. Much like how with strafe shooting, once we get to our desired location, we release the A key. But, on top of just letting go of the A key, we simultaneously tap the D key at the same time as the A key release. The key here is to pay attention to how that quick tap of the D key will make you stop just a tiny bit faster. Imagine that the D key is like a car's brake pedal, stopping whatever leftover momentum you have from the strafe. We then shoot a burst of bullets, and then hold down the D key to begin strafing right. We then release the D key at the same time we tap the A key to counter strafe to stop our momentum, shoot a burst of bullets, and then repeat the process. All we've done here is implement a minor counter strafe to come to a standstill faster when we're strafe shooting. Next, we have the final level of strafe shooting, where you will counter strafe without ever stopping your movement. So you start by holding down the A key as normal to move to the left, then release the A key and quickly press and hold down the D key. You'll immediately strafe in the other direction. The crucial part here is that during that transition period when you are changing direction, you're accurate enough to shoot around a 2-bullet burst without ever having to actually stop. You can do the same thing in the other direction, holding down the D key, then releasing it, then holding down the A key immediately, shooting a burst of bullets at that moment of transition between the strafes. You can then combine this together to repeatedly strafe back and forth, firing a burst of around 2 bullets between each direction change. This will take a lot of practice to get the feel of the timing of when you are accurate. If you're struggling to find this timing, then we recommend you enable the movement and accuracy setting for your crosshairs so you can visually see when you are accurate. Another tip to help make sure you're accurate is to use a marshal while you're practicing, since if you're inaccurate, it will be much more obvious as the bullets will fly off in a random direction. What we recommend you to do when practicing this is to first begin practicing shooting only one direction at a time. For example, hold A, release A, hold D, and then fire your burst. Return back to your starting position, and then repeat, only practicing your shots to the left strafe. Then, once you've mastered this, begin practicing your right strafe by holding D, releasing D, holding A, and firing your burst. Return back to your starting position and repeat, only practicing the right strafe. Now, once you've mastered both sides, you can start practicing putting them together at the same time. Hold A, release A, hold D, fire, release D, hold A, fire, release A, hold D, fire, release D, hold A, and then fire. Repeat this back and forth, making sure your bullets are perfectly accurate every time you shoot. And lastly, the final step is to do this back and forth method, but also begin moving your crosshair to keep it on the same location. This will help replicate a real game example of strafe shooting and counter strafing as fast as you can while aiming at an opponent's head. Great, now let's discuss the real game situations where you'll be using these mechanics. One of the most obvious scenarios will be during those long-range rifle duels. For example, let's say you're peeking C-long on Haven. This is very far, around 40 meters, and so spraying will be completely useless. Since you'll want to be firing in bursts, letting your accuracy reset between them, this is the situation in which you want to incorporate strafe shooting and counter strafing. By using these mechanics, we can fire bursts of bullets that are completely accurate at long range, while being extremely hard to hit and evasive compared to the enemy that is standing still. Additionally, your pistol skills will rise swiftly by having counter strafing under your belt. With the Classic and Ghost being semi-automatic guns, you'll naturally have some downtime between your one taps if you're waiting for the recoil to reset, which you should be at medium to long ranges. With strafe shooting and counter strafing, you can repeatedly move left and right while shooting during those momentary turns. This creates an effect where you can fight with consistently accurate tap fires but maintain high speed movement to make your opponent's shot much harder. Adding this to your pistol round repertoire will give you a giant leg up on your opponents if they struggle to mimic your mechanics. The next situation you'll want to use the strafe shoot and counter strafe mechanics in are for peeking angles and pre-firing them. Instead of strafe shooting in the open, we can simply use the mechanic to peek around a corner and then get back to cover really fast. This is known as a jiggle peek. The value of this is that you can peek an angle and gain information while putting yourself at a low risk of being killed. However, what's even more powerful is when you pre-fire common locations that enemies hold from, you have a free chance at an instant headshot. This allows you to quickly fire an accurate shot at an enemy while then getting back to cover before they can even react and fire back. Now that we went over the best scenarios on when to strafe shoot, let's bring up some encounters where it would be best not to implement this strategy. During close range duels, choosing not to strafe shoot but instead running gun can be a better option. Let's imagine that on pistol round, you're pushing into garage on Haven as an attacker. You immediately swing right while clearing the angle behind the door to your left. You notice your opponent is hiding there, so to initiate the fight, you start shooting without even stopping your strafe. If you instead try to strafe shoot here to clear this close range angle, you may be giving the other player an easy shot since you're already close and you're not moving. Even if you do want to be 100% accurate for this duel, you have to take into account how close you are as well. If you choose to never stop sprinting when near, you are making this shot insanely hard for them since they have to fully adjust their mouse position. This is much more obvious whenever the opponent misses their first shot, ruining their main chance of slowing your movement down by tagging you. Maintaining your sprint here and spam tapping the ghost in most cases will get the job done. The enemy dies and you create a huge amount of space for your team to follow without even taking a single break. You can even apply this same tactic with rifles, but with a slightly different idea. Let's break down this clip of Somm from Dignitas holding B site on Haven. Somm is playing A Link here, but leaning more towards within B site itself. When the combination of Reyna's flash, Jett's smoke, and Jett's dash comes in, Somm recognizes that his position near the center box of B is probably not ideal if this is a full-on rush. Where Somm is located currently does not have easy access to cover or a solid escape route. If Somm decides to strafe shoot to take this fight where he is standing, he would either get one kill and get traded immediately or get completely run over since Jett covered so much distance already. Somm, understanding that this is likely the outcome if he commits, he sprints backward into A Link to reposition while simultaneously shooting into the Jett smoke to find a kill on her. The mixture of Jett being so close and Somm knowing he needs to move to a different spot is the reasoning behind why he chooses to run and gun while running backward. This one decision gave Somm two vital frags as well as living for as long as possible so his teammates could rotate safely. It's clearly obvious that pro players such as Somm have mastery over their ability to counterstrafe if they need it. However, it takes an amazing player to realize when you shouldn't use it to gain all of the benefits in every situation. And finally, the last example we'll be going over is at medium ranges with the rifle. When you're at around 25 meters, this would be considered medium range. Let's say you're running out in the open and suddenly make contact with an enemy. In this situation, it's better to crouch and commit to a full spray. This is because with good spray control, you're able to accurately hit the enemy at this range with an extremely high rate of fire. If we made the mistake of trying to strafe shoot, we'd be only shooting a small burst of maybe 2 or 3 bullets, then moving, at which point we'd die to the enemy's spray before we could even get to our next strafe point when we'd release our next volley of shots. And remember, if you want to improve, win more gunfights, and get the rank you've always wanted, then check out skillcap.com. Link in the description below. Otherwise, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon to get more premium guides just like this one. We here at SkillCap want to thank you for watching and we'll catch you in the next one.